So good morning, good evening, good afternoon, wherever you are in the different parts of the world, green morning, green afternoon, and green evening. A very hearty welcome to all our brothers and sisters, those are watching this program from Canada, Latin America, and United States, whether you're on the Eastern Shore or you're on the Western Shore. All my advisors, our presidents, our research teams, and all the fellows, those are bringing the whole global community together, our deep gratitudes and thanks to all of you. We hope, because it's early morning in Canada, United States, and Latin America, you're taking care of your health, you're taking care of your wellness, and at the same time, you're having some exercise, yoga, meditation, naturopathy, nutrition, good food, good thought process, and keeping yourself fit is very, very important. If you can, remain fit at home and avoid going to hospital and catching infection anywhere. That is something very important we would like to tell you. Boost your immunity. And if you're mentally strong, your body will follow you. There is nothing to worry. So let me come from that particular continent to Europe. All our brothers and sisters, those are watching in different countries in Europe, I hope you had a wonderful lunch. So before you go for your evening tea and coffee, let's share a couple of moments together through this particular webinar where we bring every evening a powerful evening, a vibrant evening, innovative evening, and the efforts are how to make education relevant world over. So ladies and gentlemen, all our brothers and sisters, those are joining from different countries in Europe, stay tuned in, take care of your health, look after yourself, look after your family, look after your neighbors, look after your community, look after everybody whosoever is directly or indirectly associated with you in your area. Let me move from there to Central Asia. Hearty welcome to all my brothers and sisters and fellow citizens, NRIs, non-resident Indians, those are at present in Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan, Afghanistan. When I come to South Asia, we have got the people from Bhutan, we have got people from Nepal, Maldives, Sri Lanka. Hearty welcome to all of you. I'm moving further, coming to the Middle East. I'm so grateful every evening we get tons and tons of people coming on Facebook, watch parties, Dr. Gulshan Sharma's page, and some of us, those join us directly on the webinar as well. Hearty welcome to all of you, particularly from Kuwait, Oman, Doha, Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, Dubai. Hearty welcome to all of you. Thank you very much for joining us this evening. People, those are with us over here at almost 4 minutes past 7 p.m. in India. Namaskar, pranam. Aap sabhi ka hardik swagat hai aaj ke webinar mein. Hum 74वीं पायदान पर जिस तरीके से बिना का गीतमाला आती थी, आज हमारा 74वां प्रोग्राम है. एंड वी हैव गॉट अ वेरी यंग एंड अ वाइब्रेंट एंड एनर्जेटिक स्पीकर एंड डिस्टिंग्विश्ड गेस्ट एंड एस्टीम्ड गेस्ट विद अस दिस इवनिंग, हु इज गोइंग टू शेयर लॉट विद ऑल ऑफ यू, वेदर यू आर ए स्टूडेंट और यू आर एजुकेटर, यू आर ए काउंसलर, यू आर ए साइकोलॉजिस्ट और यू आर ए टेक्नोक्रैट who is trying to empower the global community and the humanity at this point of time, particularly when almost about 1.6 billion children are locked and they are away from their schools, colleges, universities, polytechnics, ITIs, wherever they are world over. We respect all of you like doctors, nurses, and paramedical people. You are also warriors in your own way, those are in education fraternity. So ladies and gentlemen, you will be meeting soon. Before that, because every day a lot of people join us for the first time, I'll show you a couple of slides before I introduce to my today's speaker and I hand you over. So from India, I'm going to take you to Southeast Asia. 650 million people population. We are so thankful to all of you, right, starting from Myanmar to Cambodia to Laos, Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, Indonesia, Philippines, Vietnam. And when I come little further beyond ASEAN, 270 families join us each day from Bahrain. I'm thankful to Geeta Chopra and Rajnishi bringing everybody on this particular platform. As far as people are concerned in Australia, New Zealand, and Fiji, let them dream about this particular program and they can watch this program on Facebook and YouTube tomorrow morning. when they get up and they enjoy and they rejuvenate themselves. So ladies and gentlemen, let me share a couple of slides so that you know the entire thing. First of all, deepest and the heartiest congratulations to the entire cabinet in India, because the new education policy which has come in India, this is a wonderful, vibrant policy which gives so much of flexibility and so much of scope for all of us, whether in the school education or higher education, and the vocational, the skills and the competencies they have brought into the multifold. And nothing could have been more pious, and nothing could have been such a beautiful moment when I shared with Asha Bhosle ji, the playback singer in India, and she tells, I would like to congratulate the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi, and the Education Minister of India, Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank ji, and all the other stakeholders, those are in the Ministry of Education, directly or indirectly with the skills and competencies as well. Such a policy where there is no tight compartments between art, commerce, and science. And now with the science, you can enjoy music also. With the commerce, you can take fashion designing also. Nothing could have been more pious. And the regional language, local language, your whole community and mothers, those are bringing up the children, nothing is more vibrant, pious, and good to take the cultural heritage further than to have the present education policy. And our deepest regards to Dr. Kasturi Rangan ji also, the chairperson of this particular education policy. So ladies and gentlemen, world over, you're watching a lot of programs, you're watching a lot of videos, you're seeing on the Facebook that government has brought a vibrant change, dynamic change as far as the new education policy is concerned. Coming to the higher education, one platform, innovation. When you talk about research and how the global universities will now be empowered to come to India and everything getting digital, the flip learning and different modes are going to come into it, and we do away with the MPhil. You can straightway get into the PhD and you can have a different combinations, and after 1 year you can step out and you get a certificate. After 2 years, you can come out, you get diploma. After 3 years, you come out and you get undergraduate degree. After 4 years, you come out and you get the proper kind of a platform. And thereafter, dedicating only one more year and you can go for your PhD if you are interested. And the BEd program also coming as a new program now for the 4 years. Wonderful and such an innovative education policy after three decades in India. Of course, there were minor changes in 1992. And yet another powerful vision and dynamism that 6% of the GDP will be now spent on education, education empowerment. Ladies and gentlemen, if we want global peace, if we want harmony, and our brothers and sisters, 30 million, those are abroad, either they are working at their own. There are so many CEOs, there are so many corporate houses, so much of employment you have generated. And our chamber, particularly when it deals with the FDI and FII, and when we help the government of India, and when we try, 2019, India stood number one as far as the foreign exchange remittance to India by the overseas Indians were concerned. My deepest regards and thanks to each one of you. Now you empower the education system the best possible way, and that's why we have brought this webinar series. And today we have got 74th program. That's what we are sharing. The Honorable Prime Minister of India's vision, India has to become Atmanirbhar. How it will become? Self-reliant, self-dependent, that all is going to be possible. And each one of us is a very, very important segment and a part as far as the development of the humanity, our students, our youth, our children are concerned. All of us, we have to work in that particular direction. Ladies and gentlemen, when I share with all of you, this is our chamber, International Chamber for Service Industry. 1994 onwards, we started the process of getting non-resident Indians confluence together for the development for India. And hats off to our former late Prime Minister of India, Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. In September 2003, he held a meeting. And thereafter, there was a Bharatiya Parvasi Divas which started, And today you have got so much from the global community of the NRIs pouring in world over as well as to India. Monday to Friday, every evening, 7 to 8 p.m., we are bringing the vibrant, the dynamic, the kind of innovative and creative speakers to you every evening. And every Saturday, please take care of your health. Take care of your wellness. If you are mentally fit and physically fit and you avoid, because don't fall sick, don't go to hospital. If you are all right, if you are fit, if you are fine, and most of the problems, they start from your mind. So got to be physically and mental faculty, you got to keep very strong. When I meet Mr. Tim Grover, the coach for the basketball, and when I talk about, the Tim Grover's book also, you must go through and watch him and see his videos on the YouTube. He says 99% time people devote in the gym on their body, whereas you have to devote your time on mind. The Michael Jordan coach. You got to see Tim Grover. He's an Indian. He's a non-resident Indian. During this lockdown, ladies and gentlemen, the thought processes are affected. Businesses are affected. Physical and mental health is affected. And the main part of the universe is our education is deeply affected. But from India, we consider the whole world as one family. During this particular period, I got lots of time to go through what was Takshila, what was Nalanda, how Nalanda was world's first international residential university where 10,000 students from world over coming to India and 2,000 acharyas and free education, free stay, free studies, everything free, free food. How it is possible, how it was taken care of, because India believes in our heritage is Vasudev Kutumbakam. One world, one love, one family, all of us together, that's the way we are taking the whole world. Our chamber ICSI, every day from morning 9 o'clock till evening 9 o'clock, till we close this particular webinar, and thereafter whatever queries we pour in, we work for 12 hours. My teams are working because there are different time zones in the world. And 149 countries, we are trying to work out the best possible way. How can we empower people, the students, the educators, the teachers, the digital technology, so that nobody is having a digital divide. And all of us, somehow, we should get the seamless connectivity and we should get the content and the information so that you don't feel that you're deprived. We are doing a live telecast. I'm so happy. We are reaching out Mongolia. We are reaching out Central Asia. We are reaching out all the way with the Spanish population in the Latin America. All my brothers and sisters, those are over there. It's such a pleasure to be a part of this entire process. Saturday, Sunday, we do the program in the morning also at 9:30. So we are reaching Australia. We are reaching New Zealand. We are reaching Fiji. All the places when we talk about. Now, augmented reality and the artificial intelligence we will take on in the different platforms. Why we are having this particular program? What is the purpose of education? Why somebody should go to school? Why not they should be homeschooling? Particularly during this pandemic when we are carrying out a survey, a lot of parents are telling, 30% parents almost world over, they are telling, we would like to have a homeschooling. Psychological fears and fear of unknown. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we got to empower everybody, and that's why we get speakers every day for you so that they can share the best practices with you. We started this journey on 5th of June. Why? Why we started on 5th of June? Because World Environment Day and all the research which we got and gathered from the world over, the next misunderstanding world over is going to be on water crisis. The whole world is going to have a challenges related to water conservation. If we do not save water, if we do not save every drop of the water, the whole world is going to have a lot of challenges in future. Thereby, ladies and gentlemen, when the children, your kids are at home at this point of time, try and teach them how to save every drop of the water. And that's why we started this campaign on 5th of June. 500 million plus people world over, those are following Buddham Saranam Gacchami. When we talk about that, 500 million plus people, we are having the patronage of International Buddhist Confederation. The Secretary General, Venerable Dr. Dhamma Piyaji, he is gathering the whole world community together. And what is Buddha's teaching in today's education? Don't forget to join us on coming Saturday at 9:30 in the morning with yet another powerful series which we'll be taking on. And then comes Saturday evening, 7 p.m. and we talk about Ayurveda for the global wellness. Ministry of Ayush is doing wonderful. And all the practices and all the pathies, whether it is Ayurveda or it is homeopathy or it's Unani or whatsoever we talk about it, Ayurveda experts, they come. Don't forget to join us at 7 p.m. coming Saturday when you will be meeting the world experts on Ayurveda and they will tell you, and you get a lot of psychologists also, how to be remaining positive, how to be remaining fit, what is your cognitive skills and cognitive behavior, all that you have to take care of. No stress, no anxiety, no depression. We are going to get the best of experts for you in that. And then comes Sunday morning. Who told Sunday is a holiday? Don't you breathe on Sunday? Don't you take a breakfast on Sunday? Don't you enjoy your lunch on Sunday? Why Sunday should be a holiday? Rather, whatever is the backlog of yours Monday to Saturday, even if you consider Sunday as a holiday, consider whatever is the backlog Monday to Saturday, try and complete on Sunday. Every Sunday morning, you get Professor Satinder Dhiman. He comes from the United States, from the Woodbury University, Burbank, California, Los Angeles. And he talks to us on Srimad Bhagavad Gita. We are going to take this journey and it will continue every Sunday after Srimad Bhagavad Gita. We are going to India's Upanishad. What India's ancient historical heritage our Vedas have given to the whole world is being deliberated. And Sunday evening at 5 p.m., you meet 650 million people from entire ASEAN countries and the ASEAN region. And this is another powerful program. Our president, who is watching this particular program at this point of time from Thailand in Bangkok, a great salutations to him. Our past president is watching this program from Singapore. We extend you a very hearty welcome to be with us this evening. Dato Ramesh Kodamalji is watching this program from Malaysia. A very hearty welcome to you and all others, those are joining us this particular program, either on the Facebook or on the webinar. We extend you a very, very hearty welcome this evening, ladies and gentlemen. On the popular demand and the request, because during this pandemic coronavirus, who has suffered maximum? That is micro, small, and medium enterprises. I'm proud to share this moment globally, world over. Our chamber, International Chamber for Service Industry, for 3 years, continuously we were rocking on the doors of the Ministry of MSC, Government of India. We had been meeting the Honorable Minister. We had been meeting the Honorable Secretary that time, Dr. Arun Pandaji. We had been meeting the Additional Secretary, Ram Mohan Mishraji, and the entire team of the Government of India, Ministry of MSME, that services sector to be brought at par with manufacturing sector. We are so grateful. The other day, the Honorable Prime Minister, when he gave the package to the whole country, the Finance Minister of India, Srimati Nirmala Sitaramanji, she made an announcement that, ladies and gentlemen, here onward, the manufacturing and services sector will be at par. We are grateful and our deepest gratitude to entire country and to the Government of India and to the present ministry and to the Honorable Prime Minister. We, on a popular request from the world over, because MSME, when I talk about, my heart bleeds, because I dream tourism, I think tourism, I eat tourism, I sleep tourism, I get up tourism, I walk tourism. Everything is tourism because I dedicated my whole life to tourism and to northeast part of India last 42 years. And I pray to Almighty, my next birth, I should be born in northeast, whether in Tripura or in Manipur or in Assam or in Meghalaya or in Arunachal Pradesh or in Nagaland or in Mizoram or in Sikkim. wherever it is. What a beautiful place on this planet. And when we are talking about global wellness today, please remember maximum herbal plants of India for the Ayurveda. They are available throughout northeast part of India. We should not forget. Northeast has got such a wonderful treasure. So when I'm talking about MSME and why I talked about tourism, because lots of people, those are running the business of travel agency, tour operation, tourist transportation, hospitality, restaurants, airlines, they all have been deeply affected. And with them is associated retail, shopping, events management, media entertainment industry, all that. So I have taken a pledge from Rabindranath Ji, who is just immediately the past president of the former chairman and managing director of the NSIC from Ministry of MSME. He is going to bring all the powerful people, those matter in MSME, to share the entire thought process and what exactly is in the MSME and how our children, they can stand up, they can get up, whether you talk about Make in India or you talk about Startup India, you talk about Stand-Up India, whatsoever you talk about, we got to re-equip and we got to empower everybody. And of course, Ministry of MSME and Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So don't forget, another series is starting from coming Sunday, 7 p.m. So now, Monday to Friday, education, Saturday, your health and wellness, and Sunday, you have got the MSME. So we are giving you the direct access of everything besides Buddhism, besides your Srimad Bhagavad Gita, besides ASEAN and other programs what we have got. Ladies and gentlemen, we are dedicating, our chamber is dedicating the entire energy for the women empowerment. And so rightly said, when you give education to male, you educate individual. When you educate female, a girl child, you educate next seven generations, because they are the one. Those are going to be mother, sister, and grandmother, and whatsoever is there you talk about. Women empowerment is so important world over. We all should be thinking about it. And I'm so happy to share with all of you that 1 lakh youth, 100,000 youth, when I talk about the European and the American language and that part of the world, 100,000. And when I talk in Indian language, 1 lakh log. इकट्ठे जुड़ रहे हैं वर्ल्ड यूथ डे सेलिब्रेशन वेंसडे 12th ऑफ ऑगस्ट 9 एएम टू 9 पीएम 12 आवर्स नॉन स्टॉप कंटीन्यूअस प्रोग्राम बाय अस एंड वी आर गेटिंग द वर्ल्ड स्टेक होल्डर्स मोटिवेटर्स स्कॉलर्स एजुकेटर्स टेक्नोक्रेट्स काउंसलर्स साइकोलॉजिस्ट एंड यू कांट इमेजिन आई विल कीप गिविंग यू फ्रॉम टुमारो दिस इज जस्ट द कर्टन रेजर टुडे बिकॉज़ आई एम हैविंग ए मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर टुडे फ्रॉम द TEDx. So that's why I thought that I should share with all of you. Vishwa Yuva Divas, that's Wednesday, 12th of August, 2020. Don't forget to join us and be a part of this particular journey and be a part of this particular program. We all should be together on Wednesday, 12th of August, from morning 9 a.m. till evening 9 p.m. Stay tuned in. Be with us. Should you wish to come on a Facebook, you can come on that. You can open your watch parties. You can come on Dr. Gulshan Sharma's page. Today also, I would request you, please open your Facebook, open Dr. Gulshan Sharma's page, share with your friends, share with your teachers, share with your colleagues, share with the humanity. It's so unfortunate. I feel sad sometimes. Some of the people are so reserved. They do not want to share anything in the world. They want to take everything with them. Most of the Ayurvedists from India, why Ayurveda is coming in a repackaging from abroad, becoming patent overseas and coming to India, because some of the great Ayurvedists, they went to the graveyard and they did not share the information. Ladies and gentlemen, the largest and the biggest reservoir of the knowledge goes to graveyard without being shared with the humanity. It's a shame for us. And when I listen to my motivational speaker, Les Brown, when I share the platform, he says, it's a shame if you disappear from this world without contributing something substantial on this planet to the humanity. All of us, we got to think about it. You've got to add value on this planet. And there is nobody on this planet who has come without being gifted and empowered, without giving any creativity by Almighty God. Whatsoever you believe in, whatsoever you believe in, the nature or the universe or spirit or whatsoever you want to talk it, you have been gifted. Start believing that all power is within you. And I want to get, our chamber wants to get the entire world together. And we are going to dedicate, because the whole education is learning centric, youth centric. Don't underestimate today's youth. Today's youth is so creative, so dynamic, so vibrant. You've got to give them opportunity. Now, this is the last slide which I wish to share from the chamber, because all these slides I wanted to share, because every day we get lots of people from the world over who join this platform, and they do not know what this series is, why are we having this program, why are we covering this program, what do we want to achieve. So I thought I should give you a panoramic view so that you get an idea. So ladies and gentlemen, there's a beautiful saying by another motivational which I read, and this book was in 1908, and someone rightly said, 19th century belonged to Europe, 20th century belonged to US, and the 21st century belongs to Asia. You've got to think that way. Now the power is coming to Asia. Whatsoever human mind can conceive and believe, it can achieve. Start conceiving positive ideas and good ideas. Start believing in yourself, and you can achieve whatsoever you want on this planet. Let's come together. Let's make education relevant. Let's make education interesting, stimulating, rewarding, fun. And it should be not only theoretical education. That's why the new education policy. So ladies and gentlemen, this particular platform, what we started on 5th of June, and non-stop we are coming, and our basic aim is by 15th of August, you will have 1 million people from the world over as a part of this program. And that is global confluence of educators, motivators, technocrats, and counselors from the world over. International Chamber for Service Industry extends you a very hearty welcome. Come as a panelist, give your valuable suggestion, send us the mail, give us the WhatsApp, whatsoever you wish to share with us, it would be a pleasure. And let me come. This entire program is dedicated to women empowerment. These girls, they are the one, these students, they will empower the world. They will rock the world tomorrow. They are the one. So these six girls, after our today's distinguished speaker, they are going to discuss about a minute or two. They will talk about what do they feel about the universe, what message they would like to give to the universe, what they would like to share from your side or their side with the universe. We will extend them very hearty welcome. They have joined us this evening and they are with us. And as a father and as a grandfather, I'm just 70 years young with a 20 years energy in my body. Until my last day, I pray to Almighty, nothing is more pious than to go. If you have done your right prayers, then nothing like that. Going back to the nature, like late Shri Abdul Kalam ji went, he was talking, he was addressing the children, and right on that podium, he sat quietly and he went back to the nature where from he had come. What a beautiful journey to the world, what all he gave to the world. So I pray to Almighty, till my last breath, I should be talking, I should be sharing the vision, and I should get more and more people as a confluence of global, human, good souls. And this should be empowering the entire world, and everybody should live in peace. Everybody should live in harmony, like a global family, like it happens in film industry. And the anchor always invites people, and they say, and they always put in a little more energy, and they say, ladies and gentlemen, this evening the reward goes to the best actor, actresses, playback singer, new debut. So ladies and gentlemen, let me put a little more energy while extending a very hearty welcome to this evening's speaker who is joining with us. And put your hands together in welcoming Mr. Chandrasekhar, the author, the TEDx speaker, the CEOs, and also entrepreneur. Mr. Chandrasekhar, popularly known as CSK. He's a CEO, JGI Schools India. CSK has spoken to more than 50,000 people in different continents through different platforms and the TEDx. For 18 years, CSK has worked at the intersection of education and entrepreneurship to enable successful ecosystem. CSK is an alumni of the IIM Lucknow, and he represented India at the International Visitor Leadership Program in USA in 2016. His current designation, mentor, Limca National Record for 7 years, non-stop impromptu speaking. REX Karambir Global Education Chain Champion Fellowship of 2019, ranked seventh among 33 young rising stars of Indian education industry, recipient of 24 national and international awards, and he has written a highly acclaimed book, Right Way Leader for the Youth. So ladies and gentlemen, like it happens in the Bollywood, and like it happens in the media entertainment industry, let me remove the curtains and bring Mr. Chandrasekhar right at the center stage, and he is going to share his vision with all of us this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Hearty welcome to Mr. Chandrasekhar.
Namaste, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all the attendees on this webinar. First of all, I must say, I have been at webinars both as an attendee as well as a speaker quite some time now, but I have never ever listened to such an energetic person in my entire career lasting 19 years. My pranams to you, Dr. Gulchan Sharma ji. In fact, I was wondering sitting here as to what must be the age of this gentleman that non-stop he is going on with the same energy, if I may say, or maybe the energy is going up. And I saw the kind of fluctuations, even the electricity gave up on you, but you did not give up in terms of giving value to people. So I must take this leaf of inspiration from you. And as you rightly said, people who are on this planet professing the God's work, the work of the divine, the work of empowering their fellow human beings and citizens will never get tired, and you are a living testimony to that fact, sir. Today we celebrate Raksha Bandhan in India, and it's a pious occasion. It's a solemn occasion of respecting one another, protecting one another, and preserving the relationship between siblings. And as he rightly said at his introduction, in India, it's our great culture to open our arms and welcome our fellow brothers and sisters from across the globe. And we believe in word and spirit on that thought of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. So I want to start off really this presentation by extending my heartfelt gratitude to all of you who are attending, my brothers and sisters across the globe. And I also want to put on records my special congratulations to ICSI, the International Chamber for Service Industry, led rightfully by the deserving Director General, as well as all other past, present, and future presidents of these chambers across the globe. It's a great honor for me to be present here, and I want to thank you for this opportunity. I want to thank my friend, Sri Shankar Goenka ji, for introducing me to this. And I also want to thank Madam Chitra, who has actually been coordinating with me for quite some time, and I really want to wish you all the best. And my special feelings and gratitude to those wonderful little children. I don't even want to say children. You are the future of this particular nation, and for that matter, for the world. All of you are in safe hands, blessed to be part of this forum and learning. Whatever you are calling yourself as a finishing school, I think it's beyond that. It's a school which is providing you energy, enthusiasm, and empowerment to go and be whatever you want to be in this world. And I know these six people are just a sample. There are many more people who are getting direct benefit from this particular webinar series. And I wish all of them the best. And I want to actually tell you this. I'm a slightly little envious of all of you that you get to enjoy this daily. And I came to know about this forum only today or maybe a couple of days earlier. So from now on, I know what I should be doing on every day, 7 o'clock. And I also know that sharing is the most important and powerful thing which needs to be done. Thank you. Now, I wanted to talk to you today by starting off with the National Education Policy or the New Education Policy 2020, which was just launched a few days ago in India, that is on the 29th of July. But Mr. Gulshan Sharma ji has already given you a brief outline about it. So what I will do here is I will actually do two things. One, I will quickly run through the policy where I will talk about the path-breaking things which they have brought in. And that's a great opening for all of us who are in education and empowerment and with the youth. And then I will go to try to ask or answer questions and interact with you, because I believe this forum is as much for learning as much as it is for sharing. So I don't want to return back from this forum by just giving you whatever I know, but I want to take back, and I know that that will be more than what I can share with you. So with this, let me take this opportunity to share my screen and open the slide which I have prepared for you, and I will quickly run through this. Now, as I have already said, on the 29th of July 2020, we got the much deserved, much awaited New Education Policy 2020. Now, how is that connected to this topic, which is making education relevant? It's a great series which the ICSI has started, and I'm trying to add some part of value to that particular series through my presentation. So the New Education Policy, as I said, is a much awaited policy and a path breaking in itself, as rightly introduced, that after 3 decades, we are getting this, and this coming into reality is going to change the game and change the name of the Indian education sector. It's not a hope, it's the fact. And that's going to happen thanks to the government, thanks to the policymakers, and thanks to the entire leadership led by the Honorable Prime Minister, who has actually given this to the Indian education sector. Now, you must have heard of this, but I will quickly run through this. There are two things which we need to focus on. One is the school education, and then the higher education. Now, when I talk about the school education, the 100% gross enrollment ratio, the GER, is an ambitious target in the next 10 years, but it's a much needed target for a country like us. Our demographic dividend lies in that youthful sector, and more than 59% of our country is consisting of people below 29 years of age. So we need to achieve that 100% gross enrollment ratio, and that's the biggest highlight of this particular policy. The second one, which is much talked about in the media circles, is the 5+3+3+4 ambit of school education, which is, in simple terms, earlier we were starting from 6 years of age and going up to 18 years. But now the much required and much neglected pre-primary sector or the early childhood sector is also brought into the ambit. So today, school education system in India will consist of 3 years to 18 years. So that's the next one which is brought in. That's 12 years of schooling and 3 years of preschool, because much evidence is available where the brain development in human beings happen up to the level of 85% by the time the child reaches age 6. So 85% of brain development by the time the child reaches age 6. So it's brought into the mainstream. The third one is the integration of the 21st century skills, which is much required, and the higher order thinking skills, HOTS as we call it, mathematical thinking and scientific temper. Now this interlinking is what I want to stress upon, is both in the school education sector and in the higher education sector, the interlinking for research. Maybe scientific temper is there in school education, but impetus on research is very clearly laid in the policy, the new education policy. Continuing further, is the foundational literacy and numeracy, the emphasis on that, vocational education. It has always been there for Indian education system, but it was kept outside the mainstream, and now it is brought into the mainstream where even a grade 6th student can take up internship as part of his mainstream pedagogy and curriculum. Teaching up to the class 5, wherever possible, can be done in mother tongue or the regional language, which is a great booster for all children to be well-versed with conceptual clarity. Continuing the school education, it's the reduction of curriculum. It's not rote learning, it's about core concepts. So that's another focus of the policy. This is interesting, 360-degree holistic progress card. It's not about the scores, what we get in the math or the science or the languages, but it's about how we are performing holistically. All about problem solving, critical thinking, communication skills, creative skills. The holistic development of the child is what is coming to the forefront with this policy. And then the tracking of the student progress is not about the content. It's not about the memory. It's not about the learning, but it's about the outcome. So what is the application? What is the synthesis? And what is the way the child is able to process the available knowledge and convert it into some meaningful implementation plan? So that's the whole focus, which is much required, because we all know that knowledge in itself may not be of great use unless we apply it. So that's the whole idea. And this is the thing which the policy is making. Now, when we move to higher education, again, the gross enrollment ratio comes up. Today, we are talking about a 26% gross enrollment ratio in 2017-2018, but that's going to be achieved at 50% by the year 2035. 3.5 crore seats are going to be added. It's a great opportunity for all of you who are watching across the globe that this is going to be the future. So the foreign direct investment, which is going to come up for opening universities, opening vocational courses, and being a part of the India growth story, being a part of the education sector in India, which is one of the largest sector going to be. Our school system is the third largest in the world with 12 crore children, and our higher education sector is again a good promising sector. Flexibility of subjects in higher education curriculum, which Dr. Gulshan Sharmaji has already spoken, that there are no compartmentalization. And then the multiple entry exit points, like 1 year you get a certificate, 2 years a diploma, and 3 years a graduation, and 4 years you complete and you go, you're ready for PhD. Now this has already been spoken. Let's look at the 6% part, but then look at the current thing. 2.6% is what we are spending on GDP when it comes to, of our GDP when it comes to education, but that's going to more than double within the next few years. And the colleges are going to become autonomous. So all colleges in the country are going to gradually become autonomous, and the affiliation system is going to be phased out in the next 15 years. Then public investment is going to double up, and that's a big boost for jobs, for other opportunities. And this is very interesting, academic bank of credits. So no longer you have to worry about, okay, I did this particular course in this particular discipline or faculty, and how am I going to take up music or art or fashion or pottery or anything, because you can actually do all these programs and those credits can be deposited against your name in an academic bank. And that can also help you for credit transfers, something very similar to some of the universities which are following outside of India, but that is now available within India. Multidisciplinary education and research universities. Now, like the IITs and the IIMs and the NITs or even the NIFTs, this is going to be a part of every district, or at least a couple of districts put together. There will be a university which will deal with multi-disciplines, and it focuses on research. The National Mission on Mentoring, where the senior educators, the professionals, and the domain experts are all going to be pooled into a mentor pool, and they are available for guidance, support, and also some kind of research assistance for interested students to take forward their piece of work. Now, this slide and the next slide I'm going to quickly skip up, but then this is just the number, the kind of acronyms which are being used in the policy for the benefit of all the people, but that's not relevant for this presentation. I want to have interaction, so I'll be skipping this. So these are the, this slide, I'm just going to quickly talk about it for a second. This is the mandate from the policy for NCERT. NCERT is the National Council for Educational Research and Training. And these are the things which NCERT is supposed to do as part of the new education policy. Similarly, the Ministry of Education, which is renamed from the Ministry of HRD, thanks to the policy, has a mandate. And these are some of the things which they will be focusing upon going forward. Same way for higher education, the Minister of HRD and the Minister of Education is going to focus. Now, I want you to focus on this 4 points under the Higher Education Commission of India. Now, they have for once made an umbrella organization, which is going to take care of all the higher educational institutions in the country. And under that, they're going to focus on these different legs. They call as the four pillars. The first one being the National Higher Education Regulatory Council. So all the regulatory authorities come under this, or the autonomy comes there. The General Education Council will focus completely on the academic programs and the plans. The Higher Education Grants Council will focus on aids and financial assistance. And the National Accreditation Council for all the autonomous colleges will focus on that. So if you see, the division of powers is very clear, where the regulatory role is done by a separate council, while the accreditation and the monitoring role is done by separate, which therefore enforces more quality and more accountability. Last is the National Education Technology Forum, where we know that technology is an inseparable part, and even the ICSI spoke about AI and automated augmented reality and other things. So technology is here to stay and is here to grow on all of us. Then, now this is the critical part of the policy, and these are my last two slides which I'll be sharing. One is shifting the goalpost. So what is actually the policy doing for all of us? First of all, look at it. It has brought the pre-primary or the early childhood education into the main school ambit, but it has also given a school preparation module for grade one, because people are getting integrated into schools from Anganwadis or the Bal Bhavans or the Bal Vihars, and there is no preparation for them. And for the first time in history, a policy is declaring that we need a module which is specifically designed to help these tiny toddlers, handhold them and get them comfortable in schools. No matter where they are coming from, no matter what financial background, what family background, but they have to go through the school preparation module. Exams in 3, 5, 8, and we all know about this, that the learning ability, the ACER report or the PISA tests, which our students have taken, we've not been doing great. But then this year and the last year, the government took a bold step that the banned PISA test will be welcomed back in India, and our students in pilot phases will be applying for that. But this is a good step for preparing the entire country and the children to be globally ready and future relevant. So there are exams, which of course is the mandate of the state governments to conduct at grade 3, 5, 8, in addition to the 10th and 12th exams. So this is another important path breaking, shifting the goalpost strategy. Third is the curriculum to integrate Indian culture and ethos at all levels. I can't speak enough about it, but much has been spoken already, integrating Indian culture and ethos into the mainstream subjects. Identifying life skills to be attained in each grade as part of the national curriculum framework. So life skills are more important. We all know this. And today you know about not just intelligent quotient, but we also know about emotional quotient. So EQ is, if not more, equally important as IQ. And that's what it is being achieved through this particular policy. 10 days of bagless internship. As interesting as it sounds, 10 days of bagless internship for students with the local craft persons. So there is wisdom, there is wealth, there is information, there is knowledge, and there is experience everywhere, only if we choose to see. And this is what we are trying to do with this policy, where children are encouraged to go spend some time with local craft person, understand how they are able to achieve whatever they are achieving, and then make it a part of their life if they have the same inclination. Lok Vidya, local artists as master instructors in schools, not just your physics teacher or mathematics teacher, but even an artisan is welcomed into the school where the children can learn. And this is on-the-job training, experiential learning. All of these things are made as a mandate for every school across the country. Special education zones, it's another infrastructure which is getting created by the government for the sake of education. And school clusters for resource sharing. Dr. Gulshan Sharma ji spoke about, don't take information and knowledge to the grave. Schools in India are knowledge powerhouses. But unfortunately, nobody wants to share that best practices. Everybody wants to try and reinvent the wheel, which makes no sense and only loss of energy and time. But with the cluster system coming in, already there are certain private schools and government schools which are already working. Not that they are not sharing information. But the point is, with this policy, it becomes more of a uniform for all the schools to focus on resource sharing. So that's another welcome. And then the teaching. Teachers are pivotal to the school system. They are at the center of systems. At the center of the school ecosystem is the student, but at the center of teaching is the teacher. So teacher eligibility test has now become mandatory for all teachers teaching from pre-primary classes to 12th grade. So that is going to come up. Teachers who are on this webinar, get yourself prepared, and you already have cleared a TET score, then good for you, because that's going to be an important mandate. Teacher recruitment in public schools or private schools will be based on the TET score or the NTA test, and also teaching demos. Minimum 50 hours of service training is mandatory for every teacher per year. Every PhD student, whichever discipline you take up, this is important, a particular and a compulsory module on teacher education. So that's going to be there in every PhD syllabus or the curriculum. NIOS, we spoke about homeschooling. NIOS is another important opportunity. The National Institute of Open Schooling is going to expand, and it will also include vocational courses for grade 3, 5, and 8. So the vocational impetus is shifted even to the open schooling system. Online self-disclosure by all schools. Now, this is very important. There may be, I say it with a lot of hope, there may be an opportunity for all schools to get away from the Inspector Raj or the License Raj system, where we can self-disclose our practices, our processes, and our accomplishments and achievements, so that people are able to evaluate it on our self-disclosure. And this is catching everybody when they are right, rather than catching everyone when they are wrong. So this is a great paradigm shift in the thought process of a government machinery. And I think that itself shows how they are able to think out of the box and provide solutions. And the last one is, in government schools, we were known for providing nutritious midday meal system or midday meal schemes. But in addition to that, the new education policy talks about even adding sumptuous breakfast for children, because close to, as I said, 12 crore students, out of which 53% people stay or come from the government school system. So that close to 6.2 crores of students are going to the government schools, and the remaining 5.7 crore students are in the private schools. So these are the path-breaking changes which are coming. And as the topic rightly suggests, NEP, the new education policy, the National Education Policy 2020, is a step in the right direction to making education relevant, not just for 21st century, but for the times to come. So with this, I want to thank you once again for this opportunity. It's my privilege and pleasure. And I want to hand it over back to Dr. Gulshan Sharma ji. And I look forward for interacting with you. Namaste and thank you.
Thank you very much for such a interaction. Now, what message, one positive motivational message you would like to give to all the youth to remain positive, to remain intact, and not to get into any stress or anxiety or depression during this particular time?
Well, in fact, when you were sharing your presentation, sir, I thought that when I heard about the whole context of this, I thought the best thing would have been to for me to talk about my book, The Right Way Leader, because that was for the youth. But since you asked me this question, I will take this opportunity to use the four things which I have written in the book, which is relevant for everyone and to all of you who are listening, and especially those lovely little students, Sakshi, Janavi, or others who I remember some names, all of you, Sarah, four things please remember. The first one is courage. And when I say courage, it's about standing up for what you believe is right. And that's the most important thing. And let me tell you this, you may ask me, how do we know what is right? But that is the biggest lie we keep telling to ourselves right from childhood till the end of our life. If you stay quiet, if you listen to your inner voice, you will always get an answer as to what is right. The problem is we create so much noise around us. There is so much clutter around us. We choose to ignore the inner voice. And that's where you need to understand the word courage. If you can display, if you can exercise that courage to listen to the voice, it's like simple turning out the volume of the outer world to zero, muting it, and then increasing the inner voice a little more so that you can hear, then you will be in a position to live up to that particular courage. So that's number one, which I would like to really, really tell you. The second one is order. When I say order, I think none other than Dr. Gulshanji will empathize with me. Keeping things in its place and doing things in its place. See, today we get carried away by multitasking. Multitasking is not about putting your hands into 100 other things, because as old as when I was in my KGs, I heard this proverb and I want to repeat it. Jack of all trades, master of none, will not take us anywhere. You need to have your own specialty, and to get to that specialty, order is paramount in your life. See, the best part is, take the example of the man who's in front of you in the screen, Dr. Gulshanji, because I can talk about that. He has been with the army, and then he has been with tourism, and he has been instrumental in influencing not any other person other than the person like a prime minister of India. I'm not talking about the name, the position. Influencing them to create the Bharatiya Pravasi Divas or connecting across the globe. Now tell me, what is that which is stopping him from doing whatever he wants when he's doing one thing at a time and ensuring that thing done well? That's the beauty. So order is very important. The first one is courage. Second one is order. The third one is responsibility. No great person has become great by not taking responsibility. Now, you may ask me, but there are things out of my control and I can't take responsibility for that. But what I will say is, control the controllables. If you can pinpoint at 5 things which are out of your control, that's fine. But you can think of 50 things that are still in your control. Now, let's take the example of COVID-19 pandemic. Yes, I can't step out of my house. I can't go to the multiplex. I can't eat out in the restaurant. I want to eat something and I can't enjoy that. I can't visit friends. I can't attend weddings or I can't attend functions. Or I can't travel. I can't do anything. But these are out of my control. But staying inside our homes, I can start doing a lot of things where, now thanks to this technology, I can travel the whole world. In fact, I don't know whether you're aware of this, but let me tell this. There are all the top museums in the world have created virtual tours where you can sit at home and visit them, read about it, learn about it, and watch 3D videos about it. Now tell me, even if you go to Washington, D.C., the place where there are so many museums, you need to spend time, effort, energy, and money to walk into those museums. And today, COVID has given you all the access free of cost. But are you taking the responsibility? The wealth, Harvard Business School has given Harvard Business Review free for people to read. All the courses on Udemy and Coursera are available free. Youth, whether it is Indian programs like the Unacademy or Byju's, they are offering you mathematics, IIT foundation preparation, everything free of cost. Now, if you say, I don't want to take responsibility, now the answer is inside you, not outside of you. So the third one is responsibility. And the last one, the fourth and the final one is ethics. Now, what is ethics? I heard that on every Sunday, you have a professor coming all the way from California talking about Srimad Bhagavad Gita. I think that is the cornerstone of ethics in anybody's life. That is, I can't speak more on that, but let me define ethics in one thing. Ethics is what is that one thing that defines you and without which you are not who you are. Ethics is that one thing which defines you and without which you are not what you who you are. That is dharma, what we know is. And I know what I stand for. I know what I am. My mom may not know, my dad may not know, my spouse may not know, my children may not know, but I know. And if I know that and I defy that, if I don't stand by it, then I'm not ethical. The court of law may give you clean shit. Your friends may think you're wonderful. Your parents, your teachers, and people around you may think you are the best example. But a person who falls in his or her own eyes cannot rise in anybody's eyes. So this is what I would like to tell you as youth or people who are listening. Courage, order, responsibility, and ethics. And if you look at the first letters of all of that, it forms core, C-O-R-E. And I say that is the core of your existence. Thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful. What a pleasure, what a pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, world over, wherever you are, let's clap for him. Such a young, such a vibrant, such an energetic person. I got just two queries on the Facebook. They are asking, could you please repeat your book name once again?
So it's called the Right Way Leader Pocket Book. Right Way Leader Pocket Book. And so that's the name of the book. And it is a compilation of all these stories and quotes.
And it's available on Amazon?
Yes.
Okay, it's available on Amazon. So ladies and gentlemen, those who have asked me this question, he has rightly mentioned. So such a pleasure. And I'm so thankful to Shankar Goenkaji, because he is just like a younger brother, and I requested him, get me good people, get me energetic people, let me have more vibrant people who can enthusiasm, who can energize, who can put some more oxygen. Our educators also need, our technocrats also need, our counselor also needs, and our youth also need. So all of them together. So world over, wherever you are, I would request each one of you, he has given you a point called core, C-O-R-E, C-O-R-E, courage, order, responsibility, and ethics. The four words he has given you, courage, order, responsibility, and ethics. Let's take it, courage is A, order is B, responsibility is C, and ethic is D, A, B, C, D. In which order you would like to put it into the chat box. By the time, let me finish with all the six girls and I come back to you in the chat box. Let's see which order, or maybe if you don't want to write A, B, C, D, you can put it your own way, in which order you would like to put it, courage, order, responsibility, and ethics. Because he told you, and that is something very interesting, he told you, nobody knows you better than what you know about yourself. And that is the crux of the whole thing. So I think some of us, we have started writing. Yes, please put it. And meanwhile, Chandrasekhar ji, while yes, conveying my deep gratitude and thanks to you, with your permission, I'll get these young girls one by one over here on the main forte so that they can come, they can share their thought process with us, and we can take them with us. Okay. Sure. Khyati, are you there, child? Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Khyati, good evening, good morning, good afternoon. Where are you, child?
Rewari, okay. India.
Okay. If your internet is good, you can come live. If your internet is weak, then you can come without photograph. Choice is yours. I hope you're fine, beta.
Yes, sir.
Okay, your family and everybody at home is fine?
Yes, sir.
You are taking care of your neighbors, your others also besides your parents and family?
No.
Oh, you're not taking care of others? That's not good. सबका ख्याल रखना है बेटा, मम्मा पापा के साथ साथ हमारे पड़ोस में जो रहते हैं, कम्युनिटी में रहते हैं, हमारे आसपास रहते हैं, सबके लिए अच्छा सोचना है हमको ख्याति. ओके ख्याति, व्हाट आर योर हॉबीज बेटा?
स्टडीिंग, रीडिंग बुक्स, डांसिंग.
रीडिंग बुक्स,
डांसिंग.
डांसिंग, ओके.
स्पेंडिंग टाइम विद फैमिली.
ओके ओके, स्पेंडिंग टाइम विद. What message would you like to give to every girl child world over?
First of all, as sir said, courage. I think it is very important for our female child to have courage to share their interests. As we all know that parents right now want their children to do what they want, and many girls do not share their interests with their parents, as they think what their parents are saying is right. But I think every female child should share their interests, what they like, what they don't like, and what they want to do in their future. So I think courage is most important for a female child.
Very good, very good. अपने मम्मी पापा के साथ share करना चाहिए कि आप life में क्या करना चाहते हैं, और मम्मी पापा को खुल के बताना चाहिए, so that they can support you. God bless the child. जिनका इंटरनेट अच्छा है वो लाइव आए तो ज्यादा अच्छा लगेगा, बिकॉज वर्ल्ड ओवर पीपल आर वॉचिंग यू. लेट मी एक्सटेंड अ हार्टी वेलकम टू अनदर चाइल्ड ऑफ माइन, तानिया. तानिया, आर यू देयर बेटा?
यस सर, गुड इवनिंग.
ओके तानिया, इज योर इंटरनेट गुड और इज इट? यस, हार्टी वेलकम, व्हाट अ प्लेजर. कौन सी क्लास में हो बेटे?
12th स्टैंडर्ड.
12th क्लास में है, ओके. So what my grandchild would like to share with the whole world. देखो अभी आप celebrity हैं, you are coming live, the whole world is watching you world over. अब क्या कहना चाहोगे with all boys and girls and kids world over? क्या कहना चाहोगे बेटा?
Just this lockdown, I think I would say special, but you know, just take things positively right now.
Okay, remain positive, take things positive. Okay, okay, fine. And what do you want to become in your life, beta?
I have taken science. I wanted to specially something in biology. So.
Okay, okay. So you have taken a science. और अभी जो नई चंद्रशेखर जी ने बातचीत की, जहाँ पर arts, commerce और science के बीच में ज़्यादा difference नहीं होगा, और आप लोग music भी ले सकते. आपके hobbies क्या हैं?
Nothing much. Specially listening to music and maybe just enjoying.
हमने ऐसे क्यों कहते हैं कि nothing much? अगर हम music enjoy करते हो, my hobby is music. ऐसे बोलना है हमको? आप क्यों बोल रहे हैं nothing much? ऐसे नहीं है बेटा. music is so powerful. मैं तो ढूंढ रहा हूँ वो वीडियो, मेरे को मिल जाए जो तानसेन ने कहा कि मैं रात दीपक करता हूँ और दिए जल जाएंगे. मुझे वो वीडियो नहीं मिल रहा. और जितने भी हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं चैट बॉक्स पे और मेरे साथ जो फेसबुक पर हैं, ऑल ऑफ यू ट्राई एंड फाइंड आउट कि तानसेन की अगर कोई ऐसी वीडियो मिल जाए तो डू शेयर. आई बिलीव अ लॉट इन म्यूजिक. म्यूजिक वर्क्स एज ए लुब्रिकेंट. Music is very powerful. You should listen to music, enjoy music. Okay. आपको सुनना पसंद है कि गाना पसंद है?
सुनना
पसंद है. कहीं उनको लगा कहीं मेरे को ये ना बोले कि अब गा दो. Okay. God bless you. Hearty welcome. Thank you. Jahnavi, would you like to come, child? Jahnavi Verma.
Very good evening.
Yes. आपका वीडियो ठीक है बेटा?
Good evening.
Yes. Such a pleasure. देखो. चंद्रशेखर जी भी आपको गुड इवनिंग बोल रहे हैं. देखो, हाँ बोलो बेटा, गुड इवनिंग, कैसे हो?
I'm good sir, how are you?
बहुत अच्छे से मेरा बेटा. आप बताओ थोड़ा सा, मम्मा पापा कैसे हैं, घर में सब लोग कैसे हैं, पड़ोस में कैसे हैं? सब लोग आपके पड़ोस में सब ठीक?
Everyone's fine over here and people. Yes sir, they're all fine.
सब अच्छे से हैं. Okay. तो आप कौन सी क्लास में हो?
आई एम इन स्टैंडर्ड 12th करंटली.
यू आर इन 12th क्लास नाउ. तो 12th में बहुत ज्यादा मुश्किल तो नहीं लग रहा?
नॉट एग्जैक्टली, इट्स नॉट वेरी डिफिकल्ट इफ यू आर रेगुलर इन योर स्टडीज.
ओके, आपने क्या सब्जेक्ट लिए हैं बेटे?
आई एम अ कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट.
यू आर अ कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट, वेरी गुड. तो मैनेजमेंट वाले, उन्होंने चंद्रशेखर जी ने मैनेजमेंट किया था, मेरे को याद आ गया, IIM से किया था, ग्रेट। तो आप क्या करना चाहते हो बेटा अपना 12th के बाद?
I have an inclination towards law, so I am looking forward to CLAT next year, and I am going to apply for, you know, as a profession for a corporate lawyer.
Okay, corporate lawyer. Okay, very good. What message would you like to give to every child world over? सब बच्चों को क्या कहना चाहोगे आप world over बेटा?
In a condition like we have right now, it's better if you use your resources judiciously. I mean, there are people right now without the prevailing services of internet and all, but they're still keeping up. We all have to take care of ourselves and the community as a whole. So I guess that's the message to be given.
God bless you. Utilize your resources. देखो चंद्रशेखर जी भी आपके लिए क्लैप कर रहे हो, कह रहे बच्चा कितना अच्छा बोला है, और हम भी दिखा रहे हैं आपको, ये भी बता रहे, बोले थम्स अप, वेरी गुड।
मेरा ना बोल के
सुना, वेरी गुड,
मेरे को सेकंड पूछा।
ओके, गॉड ब्लेस यू बेटा, गॉड ब्लेस यू। ओके, लेट मी हैव द नेक्स्ट चाइल्ड। अभी कौन है? माही, आर यू देयर बेटा? माही?
यस सर।
Good evening, sir. How are you, bache?
I'm fine, sir. What about you?
Oh, what about me? I'm fine, beta. As a father, as a grandfather, I'm pretty fine. I'm so happy. अच्छा, आप ये बताओ मेरे को, आप क्या कर रहे हो अभी? कौन सी क्लास में हो?
Sir, I'm in class 12 and I have chosen non-medical.
You have taken non-medical.
Yes. अबे
बताओ, हमारे टाइम में तो हायर सेकेंडरी होता था, मुझे ज़्यादा नहीं पता है। Non-medical में क्या-क्या सब्जेक्ट होते हैं?
Physics, chemistry and maths.
Physics, chemistry और maths. Okay. Yes, you know, sir. कौन सा subject ज़्यादा अच्छा लगता है?
Maths.
Maths अच्छा लगता है. Oh, Aryabhatt. Okay, very good. और आपकी hobbies क्या है बेटे?
Sir, my hobby is to play badminton and to play piano.
To play piano? Wow, yes. Wow, very good. Piano पे सबसे अच्छा गाना कौन सा बजा होगा भारत में? कुछ सोचो, piano तो बहुत गानों में बजा है, कोई गाना ऐसा बताओ.
Sir, almost all songs have good background music.
Okay, all good songs have good background music and piano usme bajta hai. Okay, what message would you like to give to all girl child, everybody world over, beta?
Sir, I want to give a message that we should believe in ourselves. Always believe in yourself. The thing you want, whatever you want to do.
Okay.
Keep faith in yourself and the thing you want to do will be yours and thing you want to get will be yours.
Okay.
It's my opinion.
Very good. Okay, next, कौन सा बच्चा है हमारे पास? साक्षी, आप तो मिली है लोगों को? साक्षी, आप मिले हो लोगों को?
Hello, sir.
साक्षी, good evening, बेटा.
Good evening, sir.
Is your internet okay?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes. The child is right over here before the world. Today's celebrity. Yes. Aap beta, kaun si class mein ho?
So, I'm currently in 12th.
You are in 12th. Aapki kya subjects hai?
So, PCB and psychology.
Nahin, ye arts mein aate hai? Kis mein aate hai, beta?
Science.
Science mein aate hai. Aray, baapre, kya subject hai?
Physics, chemistry, biology and psychology.
Oh, चारों में से सबसे फेवरेट सब्जेक्ट कौन सा आपका?
बायोलॉजी एंड साइकोलॉजी।
ओह, चलो लास्ट वाले सब्जेक्ट की बातचीत करते हैं। तो किसी की साइकोलॉजी को कैसे जानते हो?
So it's basically
चंद्रशेखर जी बोले और बहुत अच्छा बोले, कितने प्यार से उन्होंने अपनी किताब की भी बातचीत की, उन्होंने कोर की भी बातचीत की। अगर आप अपनी साइकोलॉजी से एनालिसिस करना चाहोगे तो क्या बताना चाहोगे?
तो इट्स बेसिकली जब आप किसी के बारे में बोलते हो या उसकी साइकोलॉजी स्टडी करना चाहते हो, तो इट्स यू ऑब्जर्व देम दैट वो छोटी छोटी चीजों के रिस्पॉन्सेस कैसे देते हैं या फिर उनका बिहेवियर कैसे होता है, मतलब किस बात पे क्या रिएक्शन निकलता है उनका। तो उस दैट्स द बेसिक जैसे आप स्टार्ट करते हो।
ओके, अब सबको पॉजिटिव कैसे करना चाहोगे साइकोलॉजी, ये बताओ। हाउ वुड यू लाइक द होल वर्ल्ड टू बी पॉजिटिव?
सॉरी सर,
पूरे संसार में सारे बच्चे, सारे टीचर, सारे प्राणी पॉजिटिव होने चाहिए, तो साइकोलॉजिकली हमको क्या करना चाहिए?
सर उन्हें बस मोटिवेट करने की जरूरत है. आई मीन बहुत यू नो मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स इट हैपेंस कि वी गेट डीमोटिवेटेड बी इट फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स बी इट देयर स्कोर्स बी इट देयर यू नो एक्सपेक्टेशंस दैट दे नीड टू मीट. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स गेट देम इनटू डिप्रेशन और मे बी नॉट डिप्रेशन बट दे टेंड टू गेट सैड. सो इट्स जस्ट दैट हैव फेथ इन योरसेल्फ दैट यू विल डू इट. You're not answerable to whole world. That you don't have to prove yourself exactly, but you should be truthful to yourself. Have faith. Work hard in what you do, and you will definitely get where you want to.
Oh, work hard where you want to be, and definitely you will get over there. Great. That's wonderful to hear. Wonderful. God bless you, beta. God bless you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, mera bacha. Khyati ko hum milliye. Aur kaun bacha reh gaya hamara? Kaun bacha reh gaya? Is there any other child of mine left over? Because I didn't see others. So, Chandrasekhar ji.
Yes, sir.
My deepest regards, gratitudes, and thanks to you. I found another vibrant, young, dynamic youth of India who wants to make India Atmanirbhar, who wants to make India better, who wants India to progress and to grow. Finally, jate jate, aap kya message dena chahenge? हमारे सारे टीचर्स को हमारे सारे यूथ को एंड ऑफ कोर्स आर नॉन रेजिडेंट इंडियंस वर्ल्ड ओवर दोज आर वाचिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम व्हाट मैसेज और समथिंग यू वुड लाइक टू शेयर सो दैट दे रिमेन चार्ज्ड विद द एनर्जी एंड दे शुड रिमेम्बर एक चंद्रशेखर आजाद थे एक चंद्रशेखर आज की शाम हमारे साथ है. यस
ओके सो अगर आपका इजाजत है इफ यू गिव मी परमिशन आई जस्ट शेयर अ स्मॉल स्टोरी.
Sure, please.
So this is a story which is a very favorite story of mine because in the last 3 years, 3 years ago in 2017, we did a world record, which is on conquering the Everest base camp with 25 children, school children, 25 children going all the way to Everest base camp. And the highlight of the camp or the trek is the youngest boy was an 8-year-old boy, Potaraju Samanyu, who came from my school in Hyderabad. But recently, as recent as 26 January 2020, he was awarded the Bal Shakti Puraskar by the Honorable President of India. Now, the reason I'm telling you this story is, this story was told to me by that boy. And that is the reason it has stuck to me. And that is what I want to share to you. He has become a mountaineer and you can always read about him on the internet. But the story belongs to Sir Edmund Hillary. And Sir Edmund Hillary, when he was trying to conquer the Mount Everest, he did not succeed in the first time. All of us know about it. He failed. The second time also he failed. But the second time when he failed, he was this close in achieving the summit. But due to some technical glitch and whatever reasons, he could not and he had to abort his summit. Now, long story short, he was definitely disappointed, dejected, and devastated that the whole country, the whole humanity's hope were on his shoulders and he could not succeed. So he came back to his base camp and he was dumping all his belongings into his rucksack and he was trying to step out. And when he came out, suddenly the ray of sun came out of the clouds and it actually went to the tip of the Everest. And he just followed the ray of the sun to the tip of the Everest. And there, almost in a teasing way, Everest was looking at him and smiling that he failed to conquer him. This is what he writes in his book. So Edmund Hillary says, you know, I could not control tears that even Mount Everest was teasing me for my inadequacy and inability. And then he was coming out and suddenly something in him changed and he wiped his tears. And he removed his rucksack and threw it down on the foot. And he looked at the Mount Everest with his eyes almost staring at it and said, I will come back. I will come back because I will grow because I am a human and you can't grow because you are a mountain.
Ah.
So he said this promise and he went. And the next time he came, it's history. He went on to conquer the Mount Everest. Now, this story was told to me by someone new. When I told him, you have to be careful, this is going to be your decision because you are just 8 and you cannot maybe handle the oxygen level or handle the stress over there. He said, sir, I am human. with proper practice, I can do it. When Edmund Hillary can say that as a human we can grow, I can also grow.
Wow, wonderful.
So my message to whether you are a teacher, a technocrat, a non-resident Indian, or a resident Indian, or a student, you have unlimited possibilities inside you. All you have to focus on is what you can do with what you have, rather than thinking of what you cannot do. So this is my message to all of you. And by sharing this story, in fact, I am feeling motivated, because every time you remember something inspiring, you can't help but feel great about whatever you want to do and you want to accomplish. So I want to thank ICSI and the entire participants for giving me this opportunity to recollect that story. Thanks to you, sir, Dr. Gulshanji, for bringing that memory back in me. And at the same time, I want to say this, that all of us who are surviving this pandemic, we are here for a reason. I'm sure we are going to come out of it on the other side. And let me tell you, for the next 100 years, the life is going to be beautiful, glorious, and successful across the world. So it is just the test of time which the universe is taking on us. And if we all hold our hands and stay together, we are going to emerge out of it. As the song goes, Hum Honge Kamyab. Hum Honge Kamyab.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. Such a powerful message and such a powerful note you have, and such a beautiful practical story. In fact, it's a life experience what you have shared of somebody. Our blessings to that child who had gone to base camp and later on further, and who got now the special prize from the President of India also. Thanks for coming today, and thanks for sharing all your vision, all your positivity, all your energy and everything with all of us. We look forward to have you on many more such occasions. 12th of August, if you'll be available, I would invite you and be a part of that global campaign, maybe for 10 minutes from morning 9 till evening 9, whatever time suits you. We will work out and we'll plan it out. On behalf of the entire International Chamber for Service Industry, my entire team world over in different countries, and all my fellow citizens, those are watching this particular program across the globe, our deepest thanks and gratitudes to you for joining us this evening over here and sharing so much vision and so much thought process with us. So let us remain positive. Let's remain vibrant. Let's remain energetic. And as long as, remember Tim Grover, your mind has to be positive, your body will follow. That part is very, very important. Our deepest thanks to Mr. Chandrasekhar, the great celebrity of the evening. Thanks a lot.